In America, we have rights to freedom of religion. This is the First Amendment of our Constitution. It's sort of weird that we have to do that to the Constitution, but I honestly don't know the history and heritage of the changes and why they were made. What I can tell you is that there are certain religions that God is pleased with. What I can offer to you is any religion you use to abuse someone is not something God's going to please with you about. The whole purpose of religion is to remind people of the lightness of life and the darkness of death, the mortality rate of America, and the irregularity rate of being caught in a snare. What I mean is the devil is always wearing Prada might be true. That's the name of a movie and a video that my late spouse loved to watch and to play and to do. But the reality is, no matter how often I might rhyme just to be silly in time, I can tell you that Jesus Christ rhymes. And he basically says, hey, you, stop playing in the shadows. Stop being a coward. Stand up. Talk about what you do. But if you're a liar of Satan, you've been sexually assaulting a man. If you're a liar of Satan, you've been sexually inappropriate at every turn and every hand. But what I can tell of the men who've been cutting my beard, of the little bitch girl who's not old enough to get it, is that any man would beat her to death for touching his beard in the night. And she is not treating any man like any man. She's treating a man as if he is a toy. He's not a toy, and he's not her boy. And don't ever call somebody boo who's not your fucking boo. I am not your boo. I am not your boy. I am not your toy. I am a man who lived his life, a very resilient life, who did a lot in life, and you can't possibly play me. You can try to steal from me, you can try to do the shit you've been doing, but let's talk about you. A real man does not harm anyone. A little boy does that. A little boy retaliates for what he views as insult because his mind is still a little boy. We know from scientific research on the Frontline News channel that's usually around 2020 and those type of PBS type of news quality programs, that a human being's mind doesn't reach full adulthood until 23 or 24. How old are you? If you're under that number, then you're probably still functioning a little bit as a boy. And let's talk about how we know this. We know this because you're wearing your britches under your ass. We know this because you're operating around the community with absolutely no class. We know this because you're talking to people and you're doing something to harass. And we know this because you haven't figured out who the fuck you are on the inside to stand up to be the man on the outside you're supposed to be. So how I'm doing, motherfucker? Have I made it into your mind that what you're doing is so unkind is not the problem? What you're doing is fucking illegal, and all you're doing is proving to every fucking person in the world when this hits the front page news that you're just another example of how you fucked yourself in your own life, how you ruined your attitude of your family is absolute truth. More importantly, how you represent your community. Is this how you represent? What is the expectation of all the history and heritage of all the people of your lineage and your type, your race, your tribe across the history of America? Were they vying for you to be walking around with your penis sticking out in your underwear in front of little girls and boys because you can't pull up your britches with a belt? Were they vying for you to run around in jeans and a hip-hop shirt and a ball cap off to the side because that's how men in this world who make money dress? Now let's be clear. You want to be a man of class, you act like it, you dress like it, you behave like it, and you go somewhere. You want to be a classless little shit of garbage, then you keep doing that. But anytime you wrench out of your own realm, out of your own space, out of your own lifeline, out of your own relations, out of your own contacts, to harm someone, you just proved to Jesus Christ that you don't deserve one blessing he planned for you.